The big contention was in the Financial Institutions Amendment Bill 2023, where government sought to repeal the provision for creation of a central Sharia advisory board from the law that regulates banking. Appearing before the Committee of Finance, the executive director in charge of supervision, Twinemanzi Tumuwene, told lawmakers that the country is short of Sharia scholars with the wealth of Islamic banking experience to sit on the board.
But then the question is, then you ask them the second part, is do you have experience in the financial services industry? And the answer is no. There are about two or three cases which have experience. Then when you go to the third part and say, okay, are you in good standing and have reputation and recognition in Uganda or any other country with regards, in other words, you're respected, you're considered a senior in the field, okay? Like, for example, one of my members, everyone knows Professor Chiriawire is a good neurosurgeon. He's in good standing in that field. And the answer is no. And then the last part, have you ever served on any Sharia advisory council board of a reputable financial institution? And the answer is no.
Twinemanzi added that the provision of establishing a Sharia advisory board in the central bank to regulate Islamic banking is not a common phenomenon in the Islamic banking sector.
Out of 50 Islamic countries, not just countries that provide, have Islamic financial services within their banking sector, but those that are actually Islamic, only 13 actually have a central Sharia advisory council, the central bank.
However, Muslim legislators who sit on the committee accused Bank of Uganda for engineering excuses to frustrate smooth implementation of Islamic banking in Uganda.
I don't think you've looked around carefully and ascertained in the whole of Uganda that there are no two people, two scholars, one, two, that qualify. Have you advertised? And therefore floated it around. And two, I mean, Bank of Uganda, if you say it has not achieved it, it's because you lack the depth of strategic niche in Islam. I don't think the governor is a Muslim. I don't think you people are Muslims. So you don't know the human resource pool.
The matter arose again when committee presented its report before parliament in the afternoon.
Noted the need to ensure the adequate supervision of the institutional Sharia advisory boards by the central bank in order to avoid a lacuna in the supervision of the compliance with the Sharia principles. The committee therefore proposes that the council is maintained in the act and an enabling provision be inserted to allow the minister to issue a statutory instrument for establishment of the council whenever they deem it fit.
But this faced resistance from the Speaker of Parliament and government, and finally the Sharia Advisory Board was dumped and the bill passed into law.
I know people have been lobbied. I want to put this on record. People have been lobbied not to allow this Islamic banking go through, including myself, but we must pass it. We need to understand this thing, not just putting a perspective that, you know, we need to be managed by the central bank. Central bank is a regulator.
Other bills passed was the Stamp Duty Amendment Bill 2023, which seeks to provide equivalent stamp duty treatment of instruments under Islamic financial services. Excise Duty Amendment Bill Number 2, 2023, which provides for equivalent tax treatment of Islamic financial services to conventional financial services, and Value-Added Tax Amendment Bill Number 2, 2023. Parliament is now left with two bills, including Income Tax Amendment Bill Number 2, 2023, and Foreign Exchange Amendment Bill 2023, which are slated to pass on Thursday to fully operationalize the bill. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.